And for a quick introduction before the video, this is what we're covering. We'll be going over the select statement, how to select columns with an alias that can be used for reports, how to select distinct values in columns, how to use where, as well as and, or, and not, also like. We go over wildcards, how to use them, and order by, either ascending or descending order. Then also min, max, sum, and average of columns. And hope you enjoy the video. Welcome back to another video. Remember to click the subscribe button and the notification bell so you don't miss a video. In today's video, we're going to go over the select statement in SQL. So in one of my past videos, we uploaded data from Excel and imported it into our database, PostgreSQL. And we're going to quickly go through the select statement and some different uses of it to start building some queries to get our data. And so from the dashboard here, we're going to want to click the query tool. And just to see all our different columns here are inside the real estate data table. So just to check out the real estate table's schema and see what columns have what data in it, we can just type select all, which the all will be the star or multiplication button, from, and then public, since we are in the public schema, dot to give the table name, real estate data, and then we can run that query. So now that we selected all and see the different columns that are in this table, let's go over how to select specific columns. So instead of all, we can just put the name of a column. So status, bed, you have to put commas, bed, bath, and price. From real estate data, and if we execute that, there we have our status, bed, bath, and price. And we can also add an alias, and what an alias is for a report. Instead of using these column names, depending on your schema and the different names, we can create a different name. So you can select status and then just type as sale. And so when we run this, you can type anything here. Instead of status having the column name, it is now sale, since we selected status as sale, which will be its alias. And this is great for report building. So now that we know how to select singular columns and give them aliases, we can go over the distinct keyword. So let's go back to selecting all. After we run that, let's say we want to find all the distinct states that are involved. Could do any of these columns. We will now delete the all and add distinct and then parentheses, and whatever is in the parentheses will be the column name that we're looking for distinct values from. So if we execute that, we now know that all the unique or distinct states are listed here. And so now if we go back to this data, we can look for another condition and an introduction to the where statement. So if you're selecting all from public, instead of doing a distinct, we can also do the where. This will come after our table name. If we just type where, we can then add a condition, and a condition is something that compares. So price is greater than, we'll say, 25,000. And when we execute, it will show that, and let's make it even higher to do less. 2.5 million. I'm not sure if there's anything over that, and there is. And so now you can see that their total rows is only 1,600 compared to what it was before, over about 100,000. So now we could do, instead of a greater than or less than that you can add, or equal to, we'll show an equal to instead of a number value comparing strings. So we could do where states equal, we have to put single quotes, and inside the quotes type Vermont, because we know that's one of the states. And so this will select everything from where the states equal Vermont. So if we run that, now the only column showing is Vermont. And we can also add an and on here. So where states equal Vermont, and another keyword will be and. We can add another condition where bed is equal to 3, because I see some of these that have 3 bedrooms. So bed is equal to 3. And if we execute that, now it'll only come back where the state column is equal to Vermont and the beds is equal to 3. So instead of and, we can use or states equal single quotations Florida. So if we execute that, there are not any states that equal Florida, so nothing changed. There's Tennessee. So now if we go down, you can see that Tennessee shows up here, and you can add as many ors as you want. You could add every state, and it will only find every column where that is the case. And instead of or, you could do not. And so if we're doing not, which is another keyword, we could do where not states equal Vermont. So if we run that, come back with every value where the states are not equal to Vermont. So that's a way to find something and to find things that are not equal to a condition. And to move on to the next keyword, we can go to order by. So we can go off of this query. So we're selecting all from real estate data where states are not equal to Vermont. And then after the where, we can type order by. And we can order by price. So now we can either do ascending, which will be ASC, or descending, which will be DESC. So if we sort by descending, we can execute. This will mean the highest values are on top. If we change that to ASC, and then re-execute, it will have the lowest price. So this is a way to order. And then we can also do price, and then we'll do comma zip code, because you can sort an order by multiple columns. So if we execute, it will first do price and then zip code. So this zip code will eventually change after price. And if there's multiple price with different zip codes, zip code will be the next column to order by. So now that we know how to use the where clause and order by and or some different things, we can also go over like. So instead of having states equal to Vermont. We can also use wildcards, which I will show a box of. And so what a wildcard is, it represents characters. The percentage symbol represents anything, any character after or before a certain point. So BL, this wildcard would find black, blue. And if we changed it to in the beginning, it would find anything that ended. BL, doesn't matter how many characters are before or after. This is a single character, so that would find hot, hat, and hit. You can add it to the beginning, ending, or middle. Brackets represent any character in between, so it would find hot, hat, but not hit. And then this is a symbol, the up arrow, to find anything that is not these characters. So kind of the opposite of this. And then this can represent any character within the range. So it could be A to Z would find every letter, or like A to E would only find those values. So now that we know how wildcards work, we can write T, and then this percentage wildcard symbol or character that will find. We have to add states. You have to add your column that you're looking up what it's like. So where states like that would be Tennessee. So now you could add not like, which would find everything other than Tennessee. In this case, Puerto Rico. So we could just put a P here. It will find anything after P. So now you can see Puerto Rico is no longer in there. And that's a way to use wildcards. We could do anything before and an O as well. And you can mess around with different wildcards to find the exact character string you're looking for. And they're very useful. So now we just have a few more keywords to go over. So we can select all. We can delete this part of the statement. And actually, instead of all, let's go over a keyword here, which will be min. And then in parentheses, on the minimum. For this example, we can look at price. So we're finding the minimum price from the table. And that is lowest value. That doesn't mean it's unique. It can share values. That finds the minimum. So opposite of min would be max is another keyword that if we run, we'll find the maximum value. So you could now add select max price from the table where states equal, where states like P and then the wildcard character to combine a query and make a compound query to execute. We need to add states here. So it finds the maximum value of a state like Puerto Rico is this price. So we can also do sum is another keyword. We'll sum all the prices where the states are equal to this. This will be a large number. And we can also do average, which will probably be the most useful in this specific scenario where we'd want to find the average of all the houses and real estate data for a certain state or city. It comes back with the average. And that's all we're going to be covering in this video. I'm going to do a quick outro that is also a recap of everything we went over. And for a quick recap, we went over how to select columns from a table and select all, and how to select those columns with an alias to change their name, and also the distinct values of a column and how to find them, and also adding the where condition to the end of our query after the table to find whether a condition is true, and how to add and to add multiple conditions or for multiple conditions, and not to find the opposite of the condition or if that condition is not true. Also like, how to use the wildcards, and also order by, how to sort by a column, whether it's ascending or descending, then also how to find the min, max, sum, or average of a column, and also how to compound that with the where to find condition, and then also the min, max, sum, or average of that condition. Remember to like, subscribe, and comment if you have any questions, and thanks for watching.